So we've got our SWA topper. This was specifically made for 308 boxes and Hensel boxes. Today I'm covering the WISKA brand of boxes, but they also will allow you to fit a 108, a 116, a 407, and finally the 607 and the 1010, but these two you'll need a bracket for. So for instance, we make a bracket, this particular bracket's for a 407, that allows you to use all the outside fixings. That lines up perfectly with the holes on the back of, on the middle fixings here and here. So if you wish to use an adapter plate, we do one even for the 1010, that would allow you to mount the 1010. If you use the bracket for the 1010, you'll find that it's a bit taller to allow you to still clear the SWA glands. And the same with the 607, the bracket we make for that as well. Anyway, I'm going to show you how this mounts on. So you've got a couple of options for fixings. These two fixings here, sorry, these two are for Hensel. These two fixings here are actually for the bracket that comes with WISKA boxes. So this is the bracket that comes with the 308 and the 407. So that those holes actually line up for that. If you wish to use that bracket, you can. However, when you're using SWAs, it's not that advisable. It's not, the bracket will or can be pulled away slightly. So it's better to use the outside fixings if you can. Those fixings also line up with the 106 holes and the 116 holes, so internally within the box there is two outside holes and they line up perfectly with those two holes there, so you can actually take these screws out and move them to here if you wish. So for mounting the 308 box, what I would suggest you do is you take out all four screws. So with all the screws removed, what you're going to do is you're going to pop the lid off of the 306 box, line up the box, pop the screws for each of the holes, and you'll find that all the corner screws actually line up with the mount itself. So you can just screw those straight in. It gives you a really good fixing. The box isn't going to go anywhere from the mount. Sorry, you'll have to ignore the the state of the box inside. It's literally just like this, just to be mocked up. Okay, we'll pop the lid back on. Okay, so there's a couple of extra features on this mount. So now you've mounted the box, you've got a few choices with regards to spikes. So you can use horizontal standards or horizontal longs. You can use one or two. If you use one, it's going to mount in the center and you'll find that there's holes lined up for that. So you can do one, or you can do two spikes and mount there and there. Same with the long, exactly the same mounting. So you can mount there, straight through there, and straight through there. In this particular case, I'm going to choose just one horizontal standard. The ground's really hard here. So I'm going to just pop these straight through here. Oops. Pop that down for a second. So pop these two screws in, pop the spike on, and then do the screws up. Typically I recommend that the best setup is two horizontal standards, that's for most ground types. Horizontal longs are really only needed if the ground is really soft. Think sort of like freshly laid soil, gravel, that kind of thing. But otherwise, generally, horizontal standards will be absolutely fine. Now there's finally one more feature on this, which is a cable tie loop to secure your SWA. So I'm just going to go grab some cable ties and I'll show you that. So what you're going to do is you're going to take a cable tie, and if you put a nice tight bend on the end of it, and then basically hook it round through the two holes. There you go, and then you can actually cable tie the SWA in place. Oops, a little bit from some fingers, but there you go. You can cable tie the SWA in place like that, and you're off. So that's our mount. If I just push this, if I can find a decent soft bit of ground to push the SWA mount in. I mean, right now I'm putting all my weight on that and I can't get it down, but you get the idea, you get the point of it, and you can see that it's strong enough to take my weight without snapping. So, as I say, you can use the 607 and the 1010 boxes with adapters, which we sell separately, but that gives you an idea on how it works, and you can have a second SWA in there with a second cable tie loop there. We also do a flood mount version of that same spike. So what we do here is I'll get a floodlight together and show you how that goes together.